If you want to see what a pie tag or a data item in your pie system has been doing over time, you're going to be using the multiple value queries in pie data link. And in this video, we're going to be looking at what compressed data and how you do a compressed data query. But you really, to start, you're going to want to know the difference between these two. So we have an example here with sample data on the right and compressed data on the left. And we'll be using this tag here. This is sinusoid because it's a great example of the difference between these two. And I'm asking for what was happening with sinusoid from Monday to Tuesday, and also from Monday to Tuesday over here. All right. So compressed data gives you the raw archive values stored away in the Pi system archive. So these are the ones that were recorded and passed exception and compression. And if you want to know more about exception and compression, I advise you look up our learning video about exception and compression in the Pi system. But these are the raw values that represent the data. And we can see here this chart of it. You can see they're not all evenly spaced, but they do reproduce a sinusoid very well. And then on the right here, we have sample data. And here I've requested even intervals, so 1 hour intervals. And they're very clean. Look at that. That's nice. And the graph of them is also very evenly spaced. Whereas for compressed data, the values are kept when they pass exception and compression, which could be any time. It's probably not going to be on exact clock times like this. All right, so if you want to do a compressed data query, let's just see how to do that. So first off, let's just see what happens. You click the compressed data button up here, and you're presented with this wizard on the right, and you just need to fill this in. So you'll notice that first it's asking for a data item. That's the pie tag or the pie data item that you want to see data for. To start off with, let's find a data item. We do that by clicking search. And I've gone into my AF tree here, and I'm looking at a power plant, and I want to know about gas turbine 1, and I'm interested in knowing the inlet temperature right here. So the compressor inlet temperature, all I need to do is highlight that and press OK. It comes onto my sheet, and then I need to know the start time and the end time, and I want to know starting, let's say starting yesterday, so I'm going to say Y. That's shorthand for yesterday, and ending actually today. And then we'll say compressed data. And now we want to get some compressed data. So first we'll click on the wizard, and we're just going to fill this in. So we click in the data item field over here, and then we click on A3. And we click on the start time field, and we click on B5. Click on the end time field, and we click on B6. And then we click in the output cell, and we say where we want it to go. Well, I want it to go to A9. Yep, that's correct. And I want to see timestamps. And I hit apply. And I get all the compressed data out. And you can see from yesterday to today, I had 2,881 values. That's a lot. If I want to see fewer values, I can reduce the time range. So let's say maybe I only want to know only the first hour yesterday, so Y plus 1H. So now it's down to 121 values. And I can see them right here. These are all the raw values for this data item right here. And that's how you do a compressed data query.